So I have been playing with ChatGPT lately. How good is it? Follow along as I make a couple of experiments. First, let's ask it to implement a sorting algorithm. Let's say I have an array of numbers in basic language. How to sort this array? And use a GVBasic to be specific, where line numbers are mandatory and each statement can only be one line. The AI responds. To sort an array in GVBasic, you use the sort function. Ah, that's weird. There is no sort function or command in GVBasic. And then it proceeds to give a completely fictional specification for the sort function, along with examples. There is no sort function in GVBasic, I asserted. The AI apologized for its mistake. You can still sort an array in GVBasic by implementing a sorting algorithm yourself. That is correct. Then the AI introduced the bubble sort and gave a perfectly valid example on how to use the bubble sort to sort the array I declared. It explains how the algorithm works, and when explaining how to reverse the sorting direction, it correctly referred to line number 70 in its example code. Bubble sort is an inefficient sorting algorithm. There is no excuse to use bubble sort when there are more efficient alternatives that are just as simple to implement. I told the AI to come up with something more efficient. The AI agreed that there are more efficient algorithms such as quicksort, merge sort, and heap sort. All the information it gave about quicksort, merge sort, and heap sort appeared to be correct. Then, out of these three, it chose to implement quicksort as an example. Because quicksort is a recursive algorithm, it needs to declare subroutines or functions. It used the deff_fn command for that. It created two functions, quicksort and partition. Unfortunately, that's not how deff_fn works in GVBasic. The deff_fn can only return one expression, and it has to be entirely on one line. The AI apologized for its mistake. Then it correctly explained how deff_fn actually works in GVBasic, although it forgot that the deff_fn is supposed to be part of the function identifier, not a separate word. Then it had another go at the recursive quicksort algorithm. This is even worse than the previous. I explained to the AI that the code is complete nonsense. Because the AI appeared to be fixated on this track, I advised it to try writing a non-recursive sorting algorithm instead. An efficient one, please. The AI apologized for its mistake. Then, for some reason, it reiterated how deff_fn is supposed to be used, after which it implemented selection sort. While the selection sort can sometimes manage with fewer swaps than bubble sort, its quadratic scanning time is just as bad. So I asked if the AI can write a more efficient algorithm. Now the AI explained that there are more efficient algorithms, such as the insertion sort, the shell sort, and the comp sort. It claims that the insertion sort has average time complexity of O(n) log n, which is incorrect. The insertion sort is quadratic by average. For shell sort, the information it gave was correct. And for comp sort, which I didn't even remember that it exists, it correctly says that it is a quadratic algorithm. Then it wrote example code for the insertion sort. Why it chose this instead of heap sort, I don't understand. At this point, I decided it is time to give feedback on the responses. The first answer, untrue, invented a fictional sort command. The second answer, true, but using bubble sort is a bad idea. The third answer, failed at GVBasic syntax. The fourth answer, AI's apology was meaningless. Let's try something new. In the field of chemistry, suppose we have a 0.2 molar concentration of hydrochloric acid. Its pKa is minus 5.9. What is the pH of this solution? The AI explains that the pH is the concentration of hydrogen ions in the solution, and that in this solution, the only source of hydrogen ions is the hydrochloric acid, so the concentration of hydrogen ions is the same as the concentration of the hydrochloric acid. Because the pH is a logarithmic measure, where the pH value is the negative base 10 logarithm of the molar concentration of hydrogen ions, it provides this formula and helpfully expands it out and gets 1.7 as a result. Because 1.7 is an acidic pH, this seems at least plausible, right? Well, no. First of all, if we calculate the base 10 logarithm of 0.2, the answer is not negative 1.7. The answer is approximately negative 0.7. 1.7 is a completely made-up answer by the AI. Secondly, the whole calculation is wrong. The number pKa is the base 10 logarithm of Ka, an acid constant that describes how acidic the substance is. The bigger the Ka, the stronger the acid. The hydrochloric acid, HCl, consists of hydrogen ions and chlorine ions. The acid constant describes the bonding force between those ions. The weaker the bonding force, the more readily it releases those hydrogen ions when dissolved in water, and thus the stronger acid it is. Now, pure water itself consists of hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions in equal proportion. Remember that pH is the concentration of hydrogen ions in the water, so we also have to account for those when calculating the pH. Here's how the pH should really have been calculated. First, because pKa is a logarithmic value, we have to calculate the acid constant by inverting the logarithm. We get about 800,000. Now when we plug the numbers and solve the quadratic equation for x, we get that x is approximately 0.2, and then the pH becomes minus log 10 of x, which is approximately 0.7. Because the hydrochloric acid is a strong acid, this number is actually pretty close to the estimate it gave, provided that we calculate it correctly. Maybe the AI made an approximation because it knows that HCl is a strong acid. Let's try that again with hydrofluoric acid, HF, which has a pKa of 3.17. It still gives the exact same result, while the correct result would be about 1.95. How about we try an even weaker acid? Let's go with acetic acid. This time it explains that the hydronium concentration is equal to the Ka value times the acid concentration. And this time it does perform the mathematical calculations correctly. The calculations it gives do really give a pH value of 5.44. Unfortunately, the calculations are wrong, as I explained earlier. So I told the AI to try again, and it proceeded to perform the exact same calculations, albeit rounding differently this time. So I told it to try a third time. This time it made up a formula where, in order to calculate the pH, you must first calculate the pH. This expression can actually be solved by Wolfram Alpha, and it evaluates to about 0.7, which is not the right answer. The correct pH for this solution is about 2.73. The acetylene is a hydrocarbon compound with a triple bond. Are there hydrocarbon compounds that have quadruple bonds? I don't actually know the answer to this either. The AI confidently responds that there are quadruple bond compounds known as quadricyclines. Interesting. I was not able to find much information about quadricyclines. However, I was able to find information about quadricyclines. They do not have quadruple bonds. I asked the AI, "Did you mean quadricyclines?" The AI apologized for its mistake. Apparently, quadricyclines are highly reactive and unstable compounds that have been detected in small amounts in the gas phase. And they contain quadruple bonds. And its instability makes it difficult to study and synthesize, and it has not been widely explored in chemical research. Really? I am looking at this Wikipedia article, and the most I see are double bonds. It has also been studied extensively, and it is thermally stable. It is also liquid in room temperature. So I told the AI that, and the AI apologized for its mistake. Then I asked if it knows any other hydrocarbons with quadruple bonds. It brought up 1,3-butadiene. But no, this compound also contains single and double bonds. So the AI apologized for its mistake. Let's try something different. In 2017, I created a video series on parallelism. I wrote a simple graphics demo and showed about 15 different ways to make the program faster using parallelism. I'm going to take the inner rendering loop of this program and ask ChatGPT what it thinks it does. First, I will make sure the code has minimal external dependencies, though. I asked, consider this C++ code. What does it do? The AI proceeded to painstakingly explain every single part of the program in a way that is absolutely correct and utterly unhelpful. In particular, it complained that the constant escape radius squared was not defined in the code, so I told the AI that its value is 4 and asked about the purpose of this function. The AI told me it is impossible to determine the purpose of the code without more context. So I went back to the editor and made the code a bit simpler. I deleted everything except those parts that are strictly necessary for the calculation of the Mandelbrot fractal, and then I asked the AI to try again. Once again, the AI proceeded to painstakingly explain every single part of the program in a way that is absolutely correct and utterly unhelpful. So I asked about the purpose of the code, and the AI responded that it's impossible to determine the purpose of the code without more context. This often happens. Once the AI has chosen a certain conclusion, it can be very difficult to persuade it otherwise. I tried many times, and every time the AI reiterated the same nag. A couple of days earlier, I did the same test. At that time, the AI actually successfully identified that it's a function to calculate the Mandelbrot set. I asked it to explain the purpose of the number constant 4, and it successfully did so. It explained that the number 4 is a threshold that determines if the orbit of the complex numbers that form the iterative series has diverged or not. Then I asked the AI if it can find ways to optimize the code. It brought up 3 suggestions. First, it suggested adding the word constexpr to the if statement in the middle of the loop, which makes sense. A condition that is evaluated once at compile time is obviously going to be faster than a condition that is going to be evaluated millions of times at runtime, except it wouldn't work. The numbers being compared are variables, not compile time constants, so the code would not even compile. It also eliminated the loop altogether, entirely negating the purpose of this code. The second idea was to eliminate the break from the loop and just return the value of the iter variable directly. This is indeed a valid idea, but it just doesn't actually improve the code. A smart compiler will automatically do exactly all that. The third idea it gave was to simplify the mathematical process and eliminate some temporary variables. As enticing idea this is, it's also wrong. There was a reason that temporary variables were used. We need here the value of I from before it was reassigned, and the new code uses the modified value instead. So at glance, it looks like ChatGPT can answer all of your questions and do a lot of work for you, but in reality, nearly always, its answers end up being incompetent and wrong in various ways. In order to utilize the AI, you must always possess greater knowledge of the subject and essentially already know the answer to whatever you ask. The AI is all too happy to feed you in total nonsense with 100% confidence unless you possess the expertise to judge its answers. I don't think the AI revolution has happened yet, although we clearly are going in that direction.